Next topic is nature, man, spirit complex. So this is a theoretical model, okay, in order to understand the relationship between the tribes and their environment. Okay, this is a model given by L P Vidyarthi. Okay, in order to understand the relationship between the social group and their society and its environment. Okay, so society and its environment. Okay, so this approach helps us to understand how a group adapts to its environment and how the environment shapes the culture and its features, the societal features. So this nature, man, spirit complex was given by L P Vidyarthi in the year 1963 based on his research among a primitive tribe of Bihar called as the Mallars. So he did his research, he tried to understand why this particular tribe, okay, it's a primitive tribal group living in Bihar. He wanted to understand the how this Mallar tribe adapts to its environment, okay, and why they were resistant to development. Matlab, the government of India was trying to bring about development in tribal areas, but this tribe was resistant, they were not accepting development. Okay, to understand this, he went to this particular tribal group and he did a study and he came up with this model which is called as nature, man, spirit complex. So according, I mean, this model was used to understand the culture and society of this Mallars, and he wrote a book also on this. Okay, he divided the culture into nature, man and spirit. So he divided the culture into three parts. Okay, culture of Mallars, which can be used for any other group also. So among the Mallars, he divided the culture into three parts: the nature, the man and the spirit. Namely, the nature is the environment in which they live. Mainly they live in the Rajmahal hills. So they live in the forest and they are dependent on shifting cultivation. So this tribe is a dependent, their livelihood is shifting agriculture, and they are dependent on the forest for shifting agriculture, for their basic livelihood, for shelter, okay, and other things from the forest. So that is the environmental component, which he called it as nature. So this shaped the society, their society. So man represents the, in this, the man means the society, their marriage, their kinship, okay, etc. So they have kinship, which is lineage, which they trace their lineage to up to three generation. They have low population because they are dependent on shifting agriculture, which cannot withstand a big population. So it shapes the society, that is man. Further, they rely on supernatural gods and demons and ghosts and ancestors and other worship. Okay, there is witchcraft among this tribe. So that he called it as spirit. So this three part are interdependent and interwoven with each other. Interdependent means if there is change in one part, it affects the other part. One part is dependent on other part. So they are interdependent, interwoven, okay, and interconnected with each other. Okay, I'll try to explain. See, why this model? So he said that the environment, the society and the supernatural are three different parts and they're interconnected, interdependent with each other. Is that understood? So if there is change in one part, it affects the other part, is what he tried to explain. Okay, so mathematically speaking, it is the sum product of these, the sum product. So mathematically speaking, the sum product of nature, man and spirit is equal to culture. That means nature, man and spirit is culture. Okay, this is what is culture according to him. So why was this model, or why is this model so useful? So after this, many anthropologists have applied this model to study tribes of other places also, and it has been very useful to understand it. Okay, so I'll try to explain this. So this is the basic background. So he tried to divide the culture of the Mallars into three parts: nature, man and spirit, and try to understand the relationship between each other and how it affects each other. Therefore, it can be used to understand a tribe from the emic point of view. Emic means from their point of view, not from the outsiders. So help to understand a particular tribe from the emic point of view. If you understand them from that, you will be able to better frame policies and programs for their development. Okay. So with that background, we will try to understand. So L P Vidyarthi gave this concept, okay, in his study among the Mallars, okay, which is a primitive tribe in Bihar. Okay, so the Mallars, also called as Mal Paharia. So he did study among them and gave this concept, nature, man, spirit, okay, in his book Mallar MNS Complex in a Hill Tribe of Bihar in 1963. So this is a culture ecological approach. That means to understand the interaction of man and his society and the nature, how nature shapes his society and how society shapes the nature. Okay, to understand the adaptation of the socio-cultural institution with the local environment, he gives this concept. Just to understand Mallars, as I told you, it's a PVTG, particularly vulnerable tribal group involved in shifting. They call it as Kalu. Okay, now, and they also cultivate Mahua, which is used for brewing alcohol, liquor. Okay, so this is an alternative livelihood for them. Shifting cultivation, if it fails, they depend on Mahua. Then they believe in various spirits, ghosts. Okay, so for example, Gosain is one such ghost. Gosain is a good ghost. Okay, it is a benevolent ghost. Then there are evil ghosts like Alchi, okay, which is considered to be a benevolent ghost. Then they also worship ancestor. Then there is witchcraft also among this society. Okay, then they have a general disbelief of outsider. They think that outsiders are very bad, especially the neighboring tribe like Santals. They believe that they will do black magic and they will cause harm to their society. This is the basic belief system of them. Okay, now L P Vidyarthi observed that the government was trying to bring about development. See, because they are dependent on shifting cultivation, which is a subsistent variety, matlab it does not provide a fixed livelihood. Okay, so therefore they were trying to bring them out of shifting agriculture and try to incorporate them into intense agriculture or settled agriculture. They were not accepting it. The Mallars were not readily accepting it. There was resistance from the Mallars against the development program. So to understand this, he did studies and then he came up with this concept, the nature man spirit complex. So nature means what technology does man use to harness energy from environment. In this case, what is the technology? Shifting agriculture. Okay, now that is the environment part. Now you want to change this, but without understanding man and spirit, it becomes difficult. So they believe that this Rajmahal Hills in which they live is a sacred geography. What is sacred geography? Same L P Vidyarthi gave this sacred. They consider it to be a sacred place. So they don't believe in, that means the Gosain and their gods live in this Rajmahal Hills where they practice shifting agriculture. Why they will not change into settled or plough agriculture? Because they consider this is sacred hills and ploughing would be like a mother, it would cause harm to them. I hope you understood. So this economy or their nature or the environment is dependent on spirit, or it's related to spirit. If you don't understand this, if you bring about any change here, it will lead to resistance. I hope you understood that. So Gosain and shifting agriculture are related to each other. Because of shifting agriculture, their social organization, etc., is accordingly arranged. See, for example, they have small population. Why? Because the shifting agriculture cannot withstand a bigger population. So their kinship, etc., is related to this environment. Similarly, Mahua is a brewing of alcohol. In their culture, it is an integral part. So what happened was excise laws prohibited them from brewing mahua. They said no, you cannot brew alcohol. Again, that was an integral part of their rituals, which was prohibited. Now there was resistance because of that. Now you did not understand the social or cultural institutions, therefore there was resistance. Similarly, they believe in lot of gods and witchcrafts, etc. Okay, so they consider this environment as their sacred geography. I hope you understand. So everything is interconnected. So unless you address them, okay, as a complex, you will not be able to get results. Because outsiders, when they come, they will only address one part. Shifting culture, agriculture will be converted to settled without addressing these component. Therefore, there was resistance. So therefore, he said the economy, namely the shifting agriculture, the social institution, the kinship network, and the spirit, the sacred geography, all of them formed a complex. Complex means what? They are a part of the whole, which cannot be separated out. They cannot be addressed individually. They have to be looked as a network or as a complex. Okay, so therefore, if you want to understand a culture, you have to look at it as a complex point of view. That means the social institution, the spirit, and the economy has to be looked into as a complex. Nature, man, spirit, complex. So this is his theory on understanding the Malar society. Now, what is the significance of this complex, this model? Okay, so this model helps us to understand how a society adapts to its local environment. The spirit, see, they are dependent on the spirit because the shifting agriculture is not reliable. So what will happen because it is not reliable, there will be lot of tension in the society. So by having belief system like spirits and ghosts and magic, they will reduce their tension. Remember Malinowski said that these magic and all are there because it brings about optimism in the society. So the spirits are there in order to address the what? The problems associated with shifting cultivation. You understood? Because Gosain and black magic, if there is failure of crop, whom they will blame? They will blame the black magic done by the Santals. So it brings about peace of mind and it brings about a kind of harmony in the society. Otherwise, they will lead to chaos. I hope you understood. So this network has to be understood. All of them are connected, affecting each other. Okay. So it helps us to understand the socio-cultural institution with that of the local environment. Okay. Then it also helps us to understand why the tribals either accept or reject developmental programs. So government policies, if they don't address this complex, they will be rejected by the tribes. They have to address their environment, their social organization, as well as their supernatural belief system. Only then it will be accepted. It also provides an emic perspective, their point of view. See, for example, Rajmahal is a sacred geography. Any kind of harm that is done to this area will be rebelled. There will be rebellion against it. Correct? Now, if your holy place is encroached, how will you react? The same way, any, you know, mining or anything that is done in Rajmahal will be resisted by these people. It also helps us to understand why the little tradition is, I mean, you know, little tradition is not so overall, it cannot be overrun by the great tradition. There is resistance to change by little traditions. Why this change is resisted can be understood by this model. So the government, L P Vidyarthi, has played an important role in understanding political resistance by tribals, especially in the central Indian belt, tribal belt. So this is one such model used by him to understand such resistance. I hope you understood. Yes. So that is what is the nature, man, spirit complex.